Good morning, gentles and gentlemen. I believe that metrology is a very important matter in clinical laboratory science. And by the reason, I will try to follow the international vocabulary of metrology in my speech. This international vocabulary has a nickname, the VIM, by this French name, Vocabulaire International de Métrologie. So, the first concept, obviously, is measurement uncertainty or uncertainty of measurement. And this is a statistical definition. It's not very important, this definition. The important thing is that uncertainty is, in most of cases, a standard deviation. This is a basic, very basic concept. And as a standard deviation, we can estimate it by an experiment procedure, and this is the type A evaluation of uncertainty. And when can, in other cases, try to find this from the bibliography and experience and so on, and is the so-called type B evaluation. In clinical laboratory science, a measurement is made to obtain a measured value that can reasonably be attributed to a quantity. And a measured value is a numerical value and a unit of measurement obtained from a measurement. This is the expression, the typical expression of a clinical laboratory result from IUPAC. And in the first case, this example, 1.5 microcatals per liter, is a measured value. Not a result. To be a result, to become a result, it is necessary to add the uncertainty of measurement. In this case, in the parenthesis, in the second example, this is a really result because there is the measured value, 1.5, and the uncertainty. In this case, is an expanded uncertainty. The second concept, very important, is traceability. This is a metrological property. Yeah, a metrological property of a measurement result. This, when traceability exists, the result can be related to a reference through a documented unbroken chain of calibrations, if each calibration contributing to the measurement uncertainty. It should be noted that a reference, in this case, can be a definition of a measurement unit, a measurement procedure, or a measurement, a reference standard, or a measurement standard. And also it should be noted that measurement results are maybe comparable only when have the same traceability. So, two or more measurement values or measurement results become comparable when the when are traceable to the same unit of measurement, reference material or reference measuring system. The examples in this, the alanine aminotransferase or alanine transaminase measurement of catalytic concentration in plasma is in the three cases, or the results are comparable because in all three cases, they have traceability to the IFCC measurement, reference measurement. But in the other case, because there is a modification in the reference procedure, we cannot say that the result or this measured value is traceable with the others. The important question is, why measurement uncertainty is important in clinical practice? There are two main reasons for that. It is an indicator of metrological quality. It's a basic indicator of metrological quality. And the second point is it facilitates the exclusion of significant changes independently of other, any other consideration. In the two examples, the laboratory A is, yes, is poorer than laboratory B because the interval is narrower in the second with respect to the first. This is an indication of quality. All people looking at these results can say that one laboratory is better than the other one under a metrological point of view. In the second case, this example is a patient with this measurement in two different moments of his life or his state in the hospital, etc. We can say that these two results are not different. There is no change because there is an overlapping of these two values. These are examples of the two main reasons for the use of clinical measurement uncertainty in the clinical laboratory. And why is important the traceability in clinical practice? This is perhaps a more delicate concept because traceability is necessary to have comparability. If there is traceability, two results may be comparable, not in the opposite situation. But please note that comparability does not mean interchangeability. For example, in spite of two measurement procedures or measuring systems has the same traceability because are calibrated with the same reference materials, by reason of the problems with, no problems, differences between antibodies, for example, the results may be comparable but not interchangeable. Now, I will present a practical example of calculation or estimation of measurement uncertainty in clinical laboratory. Always following the example of the catalytic concentration of alanine aminotransferase in plasma, the first thing is the description on the procedure of the procedure or the measuring system that we are using. For example, one analyzer following, in this case, the procedure recommended by the International Federation of Clinical Chemistry. And we have, this is an example of a measured value. Not, it is according to the VIM, this is not a measurement result. This is just a measured value. After the description of the measuring system, we must consider what are the different sources of uncertainty that can affect this measured value. In this case, among others, but this is the more important, maybe the premetrological variability, also preanalytical, preexamination, etc. The measurement uncertainty of the calibrator assigned value, and finally, the generally the more important source of uncertainty is the day-to-day imprecision. The premetrological variability is a clear example of type B estimation. We must search the bibliography. There is no many bibliography about that. Looking for some data of metrological variability. In this case, this data exists, we can find it in the bibliography, and we can use this data in this way. We have find a coefficient of variation corresponding to a pre-metrological variability, and this coefficient, this percentage, is applied to the measured value, and we can find the first component of the final uncertainty. The first component is due to the pre-metrological variability. The second one, the second factor of uncertainty, is in this case, and almost practically all the cases when we need a calibration, is the uncertainty of the calibration of the calibrator. This is also a type B uncertainty because the manufacturer has this information. If we need this information, the manufacturer is obliged, is a must for the manufacturer to give this information. This information is generally not given normally with the package insert, but we must ask especially for this information, and the manufacturer has always this information. In this case, is also we can find directly an information in form of a standard deviation or in form of coefficient of variation, and we apply this value to our measured value. We have the second source of uncertainty. This is an example of the information given by the manufacturer about the uncertainty related to the assigned value. We made the calculations, and we have another, the second one. Finally, the most important, usually, is the day-to-day imprecision. This information is the information we have in our laboratory with the day-to-day internal quality control. Ideally, the control material should have commutability. It should be interchangeable with patient samples regarding precision. It is not always done, but ideally should be. And another consideration is the phenomenon of heteroscedasticity. The change of coefficient variance or coefficient of variation of a standard deviation that change with concentration. This is a problem that should be taken into account, and it is necessary usually to find in bibliography information, or if we are working with two or three control materials, different control materials, we can have this information, more or less precise information about that. Finally, we can apply this coefficient of variation due to day-to-day imprecision at our measured value. As these different standard deviations cannot be added directly, it should be elevated to the second potence and squared, and after that we can have the root square of this value to have the combined uncertainty. This combined uncertainty should be multiplied by a coverage factor. Usually this coverage factor is 2 to have the usual probability of 0.95 as in other cases. Finally, we are now in a situation we have now a measurement result. The measured value, 1.5, is now a real measurement result according to the beam. And this is the take-home message. It's not difficult to calculate, of course, with a computer, of course. The information system of the lab can do that very easy. And with this information, a lot of people think that clinicians in general may be added, may be helped with this information. And by the reason, I hope that after 10 or 20 years, all clinical laboratories will give measurement results and not only measured values.